Now I'll show you the working of reports and inventory module. So inventory report, first we'll begin with stock reports, the item stock summary. Now as the name suggests, this report is used to view the stock, that is the current stock of the item. Now here are the filters that are available: from date, to date, stock category, store, warehouse, stock group, item name, UM type. So these are the additional filters that you could use. You could use the shortcut F5 or click on the go button. Now we can see the item have been loaded in the grid. So first is the store name, warehouse name, stock category, stock group, part number, item name, the UOM, that is the stock is in which particular unit, and here's the opening OP quantity, that is the opening quantity, the quantity that has been in, the in quantity, the out quantity, and finally the closing quantity, that is the current stock of the item. Now these over here, the checkboxes, these are the additional fields, additional functionality of this report. For example, if you click on with valuation and click on the go button, so you can actually see over here particular items, closing quantity, and finally the rate, that is the cost of it has been fetched, and finally the amount. So this is the purpose of with valuation. Now I'll show you the how a particular filter works. Since here there are two stores, I'll be just selecting one store, and then if you click on show zero quantity, that is as the name suggests, the stock that has zero balance. So now you can see the zero particular is also included in the list. So that is the purpose of the show zero quantity. Now with purchase detail. Now in with purchase detail, you can see over here the item name, all the fields are the same, only in the last four columns, these are the additional columns for with purchase detail, that is the supplier name for the particular item, and the last purchase date, and the last purchase quantity, and the last purchase rate. So this is the functionality of the with purchase detail. Now going to next, that is the show POS rate. So when you tick this functionality, you can see here's a combo for a price list. So based on the price list the user selects, the rate will be displayed. So click on go, so you can see over here the rate of that particular item has been displayed. So this is how the item stock summary report works. You can see view the stock, as well as there are some additional functionalities of, that you could be again integrate, again you could use it. Now proceeding next, I'll show you branch wise stock summary report. So as the name suggests, branch wise stock summary report, since there are two stores that has been configured over here, so we can view the stock of the main head office, that is Nairobi, and we could also view the data of Mombasa store that we need to do through synchronization. So you can, I'm just giving you a basic idea how you can view the stock of the both the stores. So as you can see over here, this is part number, item name, group name, UM, POS price, HQ cost price, total, that is this total stock of both the stores. Okay, so this is Nairobi and this is Mombasa. So Nairobi has 40 and Mombasa has 10. So this is how the branch wise stock works. Again, there are additional filters provided, like stock category, stock group, store, warehouse, item name. You need to select the date from here, that is the as on date, that is the current stock as per this particular date, that's why as on date is used over here. And show zero quantity, as I had shown you earlier, it will display all the items which has zero quantity. So this is how branch wise stock works. Now I'll go to show you the next, that is stock card inquiry report. Now here we need this is the location. So now I'll be select, you can select the location wise stock card inquiry report. So I'll select the Nairobi main location. You could select the particular item. Now here's the date, you can select the date from here, click on the go button, or you could use F5. So now you can see over here, if I increase the date, so you can see now this is actually the list of transactions, opening balance till closing balance, and here are the list of transactions that are actually affected our inventory or increased or decreased. So first is the transaction date, the transaction type. So you can see over here sales return, sales material return, issue, sales purchase. Now next is the transaction number, the customer or the supplier, the store name, the warehouse name, in quantity, out quantity, balance, price and the total price. So in the last date, that is 19/6, as for current date, you can see the closing balance, that is the final stock of this particular item. Now this report actually gives you the list of the transactions, that is which what transactions through it came in and what transaction through it went out. So this is the purpose of stock card inquiry report. Now going to next inventory submodule in reports. Now this is the master report. Now master report, for one example, is the barcode label print. Now since we have a lot of items, so if the user needs to print the barcode, the user can use this particular report to print the barcode. And in the same way, you could use item shelf report, you could use item costing report. So these are some of the reports in master section. Now the next is the transaction report. Now if you need to bulk print the warehouse transfer report, so you could use this particular functionality, warehouse transfer bulk print. Here are the date filters, the store filter and the warehouse filter. This can be used. Now again, you could use for printing warehouse wise, item wise transfer, or you could use item physical stock verification details. So this is actually a Crystal or Deo Express report. These are some of the reports of the transaction report. Now going to next, I'll show you item serial number report. Now as mentioned earlier, this is actually used to view the history of the item serial number that I had said earlier, that you when we configure an item, we could make it serialized item. So whenever you make a transaction, the item will ask for the serial number whenever. So that is the purpose. So in order to view this particular items, you could use this following report. So if you click on here, as you can see, store group and the date. You just click on the go, change the date from here. So you can see over here, this is the transaction that I have made and the serial number that has been considered. So this is how you can use actually the item serial number detail report. And in the same way, batch report. So here are the batch, these are the list of the reports that you can use. This is the batch wise detail report. So you can see the additional filters, store, stock category, item, group. So you click on the go button. So you can see over here the batch name and the batch quantity. Okay, this is how you could use the report for the batch wise.